Hi, I'm Cailean at Highwayman in Halifax, Nova Scotia, and I'm going to show you how to cut some cured meats using knives from Lee Valley. So today I'm primarily going to be using two knives, the peasant's chef knife and the chef knife. Both come pre-sharpened and are made of French carbon steel, which means they can take a finer edge and stay sharper for longer. Today I'm going to start with the chef's knife. I'm going to be cutting some cured Spanish meats. So holding a chef's knife, you want to hold it in what's called a pistol grip. So kind of hold the handle in your three fingers and have your index on the blade and your thumb on the other side of the blade pinching it. And you have more control over the knife this way. And you can rock it easily. So I'm going to be cutting some sobrasada, which is a Spanish cured pork-based meat. So what's important when cutting a cured meat or any meat is to get your fingers out of the way. So use what's called a claw grip on whatever you're cutting, middle finger forward, and touch your middle finger with the blade, just the knuckle, and starting from the tip of the knife, work all the way down. You don't have to saw, you just one motion. So when cutting a more hefty sausage like sobrasada, you kind of want to go for a thicker slice, and then once it's on your plate, you can actually use a separate knife to just cut smaller pieces from it. So next I'm going to cut some chorizo, and this is a smaller cured meat. So when cutting any meat, you really don't want to use too much effort. You want to just let the knife do the work and use the weight of the knife to your advantage. So you'll notice that I'm cutting this chorizo thinner than the sobrasada, and that's because this knife comes actually very sharp. And the thing about knife sharpness is that a sharper knife is actually much more safe than a dull knife. As you can see, I'm using, again, barely any pressure. If this knife were dull, I would have to use a lot more pressure and greater risk of injuring myself. So now I'm gonna switch over to the peasant's chef knife, and I'll use that to cut some of this manchego. Always remove the wax, and this is quite easy because this knife is very sharp again. Since manchego is a more of a medium firm cheese, I actually prefer to serve it in a wedge. Place it like so, and using one of these Lothier's bistro knives, a guest can just cut off any amount that they would like. So these knives come four to a set. They are serrated, and they can be used for cheese boards, charcuterie boards, or for table setting. So now that I've cut the meat and the cheese, I'm gonna assemble this board. So just try to work by filling any negative space. Presentation is important, especially when you're entertaining guests. So there's no rule, as long as it looks nice to you. So maybe over here I could put the almonds, and then on the sobrasada, just a little drizzle of honey. Sobrasada is quite a rich cured meat, so balancing it out with some honey is a nice addition. An important consideration when you're entertaining guests is how they're going to serve themselves. So for small meats and cheeses, the toothpicks are a good option. For olives, maybe a small spoon. And for the cheese, the Lothier's Bistro knife. So as you saw, it was very simple to cut the meat and cheese using these knives. I hope this inspires you to create your own charcuterie board.